So why do we actually do 3D scenario simulation? There's a bunch of reasons from our point of view. So visuals are universal. That's the first point. It's easy to debug issues by looking at how it moves. And it can really help to sell your concept or your product. So that's a point that's not to be overlooked. Second, 3D environments are very data rich. So you can simulate advanced sensors, cameras, radar, LiDAR, or ray tracing in general enables other sensor simulations as well. And without the 3D environment, this is very, very hard to reproduce. And finally, it allows you to do a simulation of complex scenarios. So you can create scenes with multiple actors which are moving, and you can test and validate the complete system, including the sensors, including the autonomy stack in simulation. As far as MATLAB goes, we have a direct link to Unreal Engine. So we support closed loop deterministic simulations, where MATLAB Simulink usually takes the physics of the main actors, as well as all the logic, perception, planning, controls. And Unreal Engine does the rendering, the physics of not so important actors, and collision detection, and sends back sensor information to MATLAB. Now, this is a lockstep co-simulation. That's a big advantage here. Solvers take turns, so it's deterministic. If you rerun the simulation, you will always get the same results, and you don't run into funny issues with communication delays and things like this. However, if you have another environment that is not Unreal, we also support other simulators. You can use ROS, ROS2, or TCP/UDP connectors to connect to pretty much anything that's out there, Unity, Carla, Isaac, Jim. And you also have a pretty broad range of reference examples that help you get started if you're interested in connecting to any of these environments. Now, for our excavator here, how did we do this? Again, we started from a CAD model because we really wanted to have the same ground truth for all of our different applications. We exported this CAD model. There is an exporter from SolidWorks that exports directly to Unreal called Datasmith. And again, this was a pretty seamless process as long as your coordinate systems line up. So we could get this 3D model into Unreal. And then the first proof of concept was to just co-simulate our physical model with our 3D simulation model. So the physics are all done in MATLAB Simulink, and we just impose the positions, the angles of our excavator on our 3D model. And you can see on the left hand side, bottom left, is a more abstract mesh representation and how it lines up with the model in the 3D environment. Now for motion planning, we needed LiDAR data. And this is how I acquired the LiDAR data. I placed 4 LiDAR sensors in my virtual environment, and I just got the point clouds into MATLAB. And you see on the left-hand side, there's a small list of other types of sensors which you can simulate using our tools.